How did we arrive at Jesus' birth being the 25th of December? Like me, you probably think it has something to do with Christians taking over a pagan holiday. Well, turns out it's a little stranger than that. One of the earliest references to Jesus' birth date is found in a piece of writing called the Chronography of 354, written 2 years later in 356. December 25, Jesus is born in Bethlehem of Judea. The whole borrowing a pagan holiday idea came about from a theory that Christians adopted the date of Jesus' birth from another December 25th birthday, also mentioned in the Chronography of 354. Invictus. Not just a great Matt Damon movie, Invictus was believed to be the sun god Sol, and he was also born on December 25th, the winter solstice. Thus, it is argued that December 25th was chosen as the birth of Jesus because it resonated with the pagan society. However, there is no ancient evidence that there was a festival on this date that Christians borrowed. The Big Bang Theory popularized the idea that Christmas was borrowed from another festival called Saturnalia.
Hey Sheldon, are you and Leonard putting up a Christmas tree?
No, because we don't celebrate the ancient pagan festival of Saturnalia.
However, Saturnalia was celebrated on December 17th or 19th and was later extended to December 23rd. It never actually crossed over with December 25th. Perhaps the first person in history to write about Jesus' birth being December 25th was named Hippolytus in the 3rd century AD. Hippolytus was a chronologist, someone who was fascinated with the exact date of things, such as the creation of the world, down to not only the year, but the exact day that it took place. In his commentary on Daniel chapter 4, verse 23, he wrote this: "For the first advent of our Lord in the flesh, when he was born in Bethlehem, was December 25th. A Wednesday." This was written sometime around the year 202 to 211 AD, making it the earliest reference to Jesus' birthday being December 25th. The text itself is constructed from multiple sources, but recent scholarship considers it to be genuine. It's a little difficult to explain how chronologists reach their conclusions, because as one scholar writes, their methods require almost breathtaking mental acrobatics. Breathtaking mental acrobatics is also how I describe people who start playing Christmas carols in October. It's still 2 whole months away. So let's do our best and take a look at Hippolytus's calculation. Hippolytus believed that Jesus died on March 25th, 29 AD, which he argued was the exact anniversary of the creation of the world, which for him occurred 5,502 years before Jesus' death. Now, in one of Hippolytus's latest writings, he also believed that Jesus was born 9 months after the anniversary of the creation of the world, which, if he thought the world was created on March 25th, then exactly 9 months after that is December 25th. Now, Hippolytus's maths was about as good as my French. Je suis le roi des tortes. His dates had many other contradictions, such as placing Jesus' death in the 15th year of Tiberius, despite the fact that the Gospel of Luke has Jesus only beginning his public ministry by getting baptized that same year. But his belief that Jesus was born 9 months after March 25th is likely the earliest reference to a December 25th date, even though it was just pure speculation. And he wasn't alone. A contemporary, Julius Sextus Africanus, reached the same conclusions using the same logic independently of Hippolytus. Though it's worth noting, there are as many difficulties interpreting Africanus as there are Hippolytus. Now, despite the fact that we can't possibly know how long Jesus was in the womb for, a perfect 9 months was mere speculation. Even if it was the case, their maths was not at all accurate. Hippolytus and his contemporaries tried to work out these dates using the length between Passovers as their measure, with the aim of being able to predict future Passover dates based on the lunar calendar. Now, calculating the dates of Passover in the past and future is complicated, even more so in the ancient world. And in all of Hippolytus's attempts to calculate future Passover dates, he ended up being wrong within a few years of making his calendars. Hippolytus and Africanus also had many other mistakes in their chronicon. Not to mention that all of this was based on the impossible notion that they could know what day the world was created. So the maths doesn't check out. Truly, we have no way of knowing what date Jesus was born on. But these ancient calculations go a long way to explaining why some early Christians believed Jesus was born on December 25th. Anyway, I hope you have a great Christmas. Links to support the channel in the description, and I will see you next year.
Ho ho ho. Share and comment below.